This week we cover Rocket Factory Augsburg. It's a space startup from Germany. They are one of the leading commercial launch providers in Europe and are planning their first launch in 2024. Founded in 2018, Rocket Factory Augsburg, or RFA for short, aims to build the best rockets for the lowest prices. They keep costs low by using serial production, just like car manufacturers do. According to a 2021 press release, the launch prices are incredibly competitive at only 3 million euros per launch, significantly undercutting competitors like Rocket Lab, which charges a base price of 7.5 million US dollars per launch. Based in Augsburg, near Munich, Germany, RFA has rapidly expanded its workforce to over 300 employees across more than 30 countries. The company aims to open up access to space in order to better understand, protect, and connect our planet. RFA's goal is to build rockets just like cars. They take a lesson from high-volume factories typically used in machine and car production, transferring them to rocket production. RFA considers low cost and efficiency the key ingredient to success. This shift away from complex and expensive over-engineering has allowed them to focus on producing the most cost-efficient, high-performance small launchers in the industry. They haven't launched yet, so we don't know whether they can achieve their ambitions for a low-cost vehicle. Cheap is great, but they also need to be reliable and offer frequent flights to multiple different orbits. Time will tell. The ultimate goal for RFA is to make space more accessible for everyone. But how do they plan to do this? By producing high-quality, low-cost launchers that put satellites in orbit to better connect and protect our planet in real time. Commercial satellite networks will soon enable phone and internet access anywhere in the world, but RFA thinks there is an even bigger market: data. The collection and distribution of data from such a high volume of satellites requires low-cost access. That's where RFA comes in. New space industry funding has increased tenfold over the last decade, but its market growth depends on low cost and easy access to space. Complicated and over-engineered rockets don't cut it anymore. The aim is to get small satellites into low Earth orbit as accurately as possible, as quickly as possible. Let's look at some of the technology RFA is using. Rocket Factory Augsburg technology is designed to deliver cost-effective and efficient space access. The first stage of their launch vehicle, RFA ONE, is powered by 9 Helix engines, each generating 100 kilonewtons of thrust. These engines are fueled by RP1 rocket-grade kerosene and liquid oxygen. The second stage features a vacuum-optimized version of the Helix engine. The third stage, known as Redshift, serves as an orbital transfer vehicle. We'll talk more about that later. RFA1 Flexible Launch System. Here are some stats about the RFA1 launch system. It can launch 1,300 kilos to 500 kilometers sun-synchronous orbit, 850 kilos to 2,000 kilometer polar orbit, and 150 kilos to a geosynchronous orbit. It has 9 engines, 3 stages, 1 launch system. The Helix engine was designed in-house and uses low-cost stainless steel with other industrial components from the car, oil, and energy industries to construct the launcher. Dedicated configuration. Payload can be directly mounted to the payload platform, reducing complexity and cost. Rideshare configuration. Multiple size ports are available for rideshare missions. RFA will customize configurations for large spacecraft upon request. Orbital transfer vehicle, or OTV, called Redshift. Redshift, the third stage of the RFA-1 vehicle, offers precise positioning of orbital payloads. It has different configurations to choose from, with further customization of surfaces available, meaning it can complete multiple in-orbit servicing objectives during a single mission. The kind of transportation services available are altitude change, phase change, or inclination change. In-orbit services offered are hosted payload, space debris removal, life extension, satellite inspection, and end-of-life management. The OTV is capable of 2.5 kilometers per second delta V. That means the vehicle can change its velocity by up to 2,500 meters per second. Introducing Argo, a cost-effective cargo capsule. Think Cargo Dragon, or the European Nix cargo vehicle for instance. This vehicle can carry up to 4,000 kilos of cargo, and also return 4,000 kilos of payload from orbit. Internally, it provides 15.5 cubic meters of pressurized volume. Human space exploration is increasing rapidly, requiring low-cost, flexible, and reliable space cargo capability. By 2030, experts forecast there will be more than 7 commercial space stations in orbit and annual cargo transit is expected to exceed 370 tons. That's where RFA can help commercial space stations by ferrying up and down payloads, experiments, or consumables. Argo is aimed at providing a comprehensive solution for cargo supply needs for commercial companies, space agencies, or governments. Argo's inflatable atmospheric decelerator allows for 4,000 kilos up and down mass and ensures a smooth and safe re-entry, descent, and landing by covering the vehicle completely while enabling steering control. Next up, let's talk about the Fenix engines. Argo is powered by RFA's unique reignitable Fenix engines, using a green nitromethane-based bipropellant system to provide last-mile deliveries. Next, it has an advanced docking mechanism. Argo's advanced docking and berthing adapter allows for rendezvous operations with space stations and resupply missions. RFA has submitted the Argo cargo capsule to compete for the ESA Commercial Cargo Transportation Initiative. Although not directly stated, this implies their berthing adapter is compatible with the International Space Station and likely future commercial space stations. Argo has potential for crew transport and lunar missions in the future. Okay, now we have covered the technology, the launch vehicle and the cargo capsule, let's look at some of the important milestones RFA has completed so far and finish with upcoming events. In June 2021, RFA successfully tests full-scale stage combustion engine. RFA fires full-stage stage combustion engine for the first time in Europe and takes pole position in the private European launcher market. A successful firing test of its full-stage stage combustion engine, the successful firing lasted for 2 seconds and was carried out at Kiruna in Sweden. RFA successfully commissioned the first stage combustion engine in Western Europe. RFA is the 9th company in the world to have successfully tested a full-scale rocket engine using stage combustion. This technology is the backbone of some of the world's most successful space companies. For instance, SpaceX's Raptor engine is a full-float stage combustion engine, and the BE-4 engine from Blue Origin is a stage combustion engine. In August 2021, RFA performed a cryogenic burst test. Burst tests are always fun to watch. They're also very important and indeed mandatory to ensure they can withstand the needed pressures for spaceflight. With the successful cryogenic burst test from RFA, they are moving closer to validating all the components necessary for the RFA ONE orbital launch vehicle. In July 2022, RFA successfully hot fires the Helix engine for a total of 74 seconds. RFA has tested its staged combustion Helix engine for the first time for a total duration of 74 seconds. This marks the successful completion of the first test campaign of the Helix engine in flight configuration. The test campaign consisted of a long duration hot firings of 30 and 40 seconds each. This was preceded by a short test of 4 seconds. All three tests were conducted with the same engine, reached the desired duration, and were subsequently shut down safely. The tests demonstrated the engine's endurance and multiple ignition capability. Data was collected for further optimization of the engine, which is 100% designed and built by RFA. In September 2022, Spaceflight Inc. and RFA partner to fly the Sherpa Orbital Transfer Vehicle on future RFA launches. Spaceflight Inc., a global launch services provider, today announced it had signed a Memorandum of Understanding for upcoming launches from RFA. The agreement formalizes the plan for Spaceflight to fly its Sherpa orbital transfer vehicles and other rideshare payloads on upcoming RFA missions from Saxford and French Guiana. In January 2023, Rocket Factory Augsburg's first launch to take place from Saxford Spaceport. RFA and Saxford Spaceport have today announced their launch operations partnership. RFA will have exclusive access to Launchpad Frido for orbital launches, meaning the company's first launch of its RFA ONE launch system will take place from the northernmost point in the UK. The commercial spaceport in Shetland is ideally located for RFA to launch payloads at a high cadence into polar and sun-synchronous orbits. Existing logistics and infrastructure and launch readiness were key factors for RFA in deciding to partner with Saxford. This is a multi-year partnership which includes investments in the double-digit million-pound range. RFA is securing its first flight launch site in order to be able to provide its services individually and flexibly to customer requirements. The partnership allows RFA to launch satellites, the majority of which are active in two major areas, Earth observation and communications. In May 2023, 280 seconds, RFA completes full duration upper stage hot fire. RFA has successfully hot fired its upper stage for a full duration of 280 seconds. This marks the successful completion of the integrated system test campaign, in which a stage combustion helix engine was integrated into an upper stage tank system and hot fired several times up to full duration in the final tests. This is the first time a European space startup has developed and successfully hot fired a stage combustion upper stage engine. RFA has signed a binding term sheet with the French Space Agency to offer its launch services from Kourou Space Center in French Guiana. The first expected launch from RFA will likely be in 2025 at the earliest. This agreement will allow RFA to offer its customers more comprehensive orbital missions. French Guiana is optimal for equatorial orbits, while Saxeford in Scotland is great for polar orbits. Low inclination orbits are better for missions that go further, e.g. to the moon or deep space, as the extra kick from launching from the equator helps. In October 2023, three German new space companies launched EVA, the world's first end-to-end microgravity surface for biotech research and product development. Three German new space companies, RFA, URI, and Atmos Space Cargo, have launched EVA, the world's first end-to-end microgravity surface for biotech research and product development. This service, available from 2025, is designed to meet the increasing demand from the life sciences industry. URI develops modular bioreactors and incubators for use in microgravity environments to enhance the development and production of biotech products. Atmos Space Cargo contributes reusable, modular, and scalable return space capsules suitable for any scientific payload or experiment. This joint venture aims to offer a private commercial alternative to the International Space Station. The total in-space manufacturing market is projected to reach 7 billion euros by 2030, highlighting the growth potential of this sector. The launch campaigns are to be carried out from Saxeford Spaceport. Atmos will supervise and execute the safe return from low Earth orbit to the Azores Islands, those islands off the coast of Portugal, and carry out the early retrieval of the capsule after landing, as well as the recovery mission to the final location. In May 2024, the first stage arrives in Saxeford in preparation for the start of the hot fire campaign. The first stage of RFA ONE has successfully arrived at the Saxeford spaceport. There it will be lifted onto the launch pad and is now being prepared for its hot fire campaign. In May 2024, the very first static fire was carried out by RFA at Saxeford. The tweet from RFA said, "First fire, we have successfully kicked off the hot fire campaign for our first stage at Saxeford Space. We hot fired a total of four helix engines, igniting one by one at 4 second intervals. All engines ran simultaneously for 8 seconds with a total hot fire duration of 20 seconds. The test ran flawlessly through startup, steady state, and shutdown. With this hot fire, we are able to demonstrate that we can nominally operate and control our first stage and all its systems, as well as a cluster of helix engines. RFA and our incredible team are marching steadfastly on towards our first test flight. Special thanks to our partners at Saxeford Space for all their support at all levels." In July 2024, did RFA fire 9 engines at Saxeford? Some video has emerged of a full duration static fire of all 9 helix engines at Saxeford. Video from Angry Astronaut channel seems to show a successful static fire. At the time of this video, RFA has not officially confirmed this yet. Okay, let's move on to upcoming events. Launch of the inaugural flight of RFA ONE is imminent. It's expected in summer 2024. Saxeford still has some outstanding licensing needed for launches, but they should be resolved soon. Then we can look forward to the first commercial orbital launch from Europe. We can't wait to see this historic launch and eagerly look forward to this new era of commercial launches from Europe. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to stay in the loop on the latest developments from space startups. This space startup scene is more than just launch providers. It includes commercial space stations, in-space operations such as orbital tugs, refueling stations, orbital debris removal, power generation, lunar infrastructure, and asteroid mining. From the latest news on Earth to the latest discoveries in orbit and beyond, we've got you covered. Until next time.